And today, we're going to talk about women's hair loss. Hello everyone, I'm Lynn Tan, your hair care guru. I've been in the hair care industry for the past 20 years, and I'm here to share with you everything I've learned about scalp care and hair care. Are you ready? Let's go! So today, we're talking about reactive alopecia. So ladies, listen up. So a few things that causes reactive alopecia. Okay, first and foremost, it's physical stress. Physical stress are things that we put onto ourselves, meaning you did over-coloring, over-bleaching, too much chemical work, over-styling, things that are harsh on the hair and the scalp that could cause it. It could be emotional stress, meaning we're going through a really tough time in our lives. Too much life changes, maybe we're moving house, kids giving us troubles, getting into a relationship, getting out of one, changing jobs, COVID, depression, etc., etc. So these are the emotional stress. It could be chemical stress, meaning you are taking medication, therefore there's some side effects causing hair loss. You could be having some lymphatic imbalance, things like this. One of the common ones that women have reactive alopecia from is because of postpartum hair loss after we gave birth. So for me, I'm a mother of three. I'm totally aware of how this happens because I suffered from it three times. Yes. So these are the various causes that you could look into that would cause hair loss. Oh, sometimes it's also because you're going through a diet, you want to change diet or you want to lose weight, and it's a massive weight loss diet you're going through, and then you lose the essential nutrients that you need to ensure that you have healthy hair growth. So the good news is, ladies, is all these things can be fixed, and compared to chronic hair loss, reactive alopecia is temporary. Yes, it's temporary hair loss, it is not permanent. However, it does not mean you do nothing about it, okay? In the past 20 years, I've seen many ladies who come to me and they've had hair loss and they did nothing about it because they feel like, oh, it's gonna go back to normal anyways in a few months, because temporary hair loss could last between 6 months to 2 years. So I'll take it easy. However, unfortunately, most of them are not so lucky. Their hair does not grow back to the same density that they used to have. So we wouldn't want that, right? So what can we do? What can we do then to ensure that that does not happen? What can we do to make sure that we grow back to the same density that we used to have? Okay? So if you're suffering from reactive alopecia, there's a few things you must note. Is you could use the right products to help you, at least during that period. There are products out there in the market which really helps women's hair loss. So find the product that is targeted for women's hair loss and not just hair loss in general. Because as you know from me, as you've learned, there are different types of hair loss. Yeah, so get the right hair loss treatment that's suited especially for women, because it's for a temporary hair loss. Yeah. And also, we are what we eat, right? We are what we eat. It's important for us to eat the right nutrients during this period of time, yeah? To make sure that we have good biotin, ingredients that have biotins in it. Like fish, oily fish, spinach, vitamin B's, vitamin C, antioxidants, etc., etc. Or take supplements that helps with hair growth. The good news is, products that help with hair growth also helps with your nails. So a natural supplement, dietary supplement that you can eat definitely will help you with your hair and also help you with your nails. What other things can we do? We could also watch the way we shampoo, because sometimes we shampoo wrongly. We're so used to shampooing the hair, we don't shampoo the scalp. Or we use conditioners. We use conditioners which are filled with lots and lots of silicone, and we use them all over the scalp, clogging the scalp. So that doesn't really help us if we're suffering from hair loss and we need our scalp to be really clean and healthy, because chances are it's full of sebum and we need to make it really clean. especially during this period. So it's very important that we use the right shampoo and conditioner, preferably one that is non-silicone. Yeah, you will see my videos, I'm always advocating choose products for your hair that is non-silicone. Those that you wash on your shampoo and your rinse off conditioners, please get silicone free products. Yeah, because it's really bad for your scalp. So if you're having hair loss right now, ladies, let's remember that it's not something that happened today that you did or yesterday. It was something that happened 2 to 3 months ago. So 2 to 3 months ago, something happened to your body and therefore you're having reactive alopecia. So like for me, after I've given birth, it will not be tomorrow my hair loss happens. It will only happen 2 to 3 months later. Why? Because when our body gets into shock, all our hair from the anagen phase, which is the growth stage, will all jump into the telogen phase, which is the stage where it's waiting to fall off. And even if it jumps to the telogen phase after I've given birth, that whole period takes about 2 to 3 months for the hair to slowly push itself out for it to fall off. So by the time it's visibly possible for you to see all the hair falling off, it's actually about 3 months later. So when your baby is like 3 months old, you will see that you're having lots of hair loss. So that's the time you will notice massive hair loss. So the thing is, if you're having lots of hair loss right now, ladies, think back what happened to you 2 to 3 months ago. Yeah, because that's what is the real trigger for your reactive alopecia. So I've been asked the question, what can I do now, Lynn, now that I'm going through my reactive alopecia and I want my hair to still look fuller while I'm going through my treatment, right? And that takes a few months. That's a really good question and I'm going to help you answer it. I've got a few tips for you. Number one is you could change your parting. See, just by changing your hair parting, that itself is an instant way to give you volume. Number two, you could consider using volumizing products. I love my volumizing spray. After I shampoo, I towel dry, I spray it at my roots, yeah, and then I blow dry. It gives me nice bounce and volume. Number three is I could change my hairstyle. A simple haircut can make a lot of difference. I could go for a blunt cut. Cutting it really blunt and straight gives the illusion of fullness. The fourth tip I have is hair coloring. I'm not a huge advocate of hair coloring, but well, sometimes we need to have it. We could do an illusion of hair coloring that gives you fuller hair. By having your roots dark and your hair lighter at the ends, it gives that illusion of density. The roots are dark and the hair ends are light. So these are the four tips I would like to share with you that you could do immediately, you know, in the next 6 months while you're doing your hair loss treatment process to get back to this fullness. This is a great way to give you volumizing dense hair. So if you've learned something today, if you've liked what you've seen and you want to learn more, please like and share and follow me.